a 360-degree circle, a gymnast performs at a single bar. A giant can be explained in, using Sir Isaac Newton's three laws of motion. His first law, an object at rest will stay at rest, and an object in motion will stay in motion at a constant speed in a straight line unless acted on by an unbalanced force. This, the first law, can be seen in the cast of the giant. Objects like to stay still. And objects will stay still unless a force acts upon them. A gymnast will stay still on the bar unless a force herself acts on them. That force is a cast. A cast is when a gymnast swings her legs up in the air trying to get to the handstand. A cast provides angular momentum. Angular momentum is the product of the momentum of the rotating body and its distance from the axis of rotation. Without a cast, a gymnast will never be able to do a jump. She will remain at rest on the bar. Newton's second law of motion states that an object's acceleration is due to the object's mass and the amount of force applied. The second law is seen in the tap or kick the gymnast does at the bottom of the bar. A tap helps a gymnast keep going around the bar. With the right amount of tap at the bottom of the bar, a gymnast can overcome gravity. The tap is the force applied to accelerate. So the heavier the gymnast is, the stronger tap she will need to overcome gravity. Newton's third law states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Newton's third law is seen throughout the entire giant. When a gymnast pushes down on the bar exerts an equal push-up on the gymnast. Some labs that we have done in class that relate to gymnastics are the driving while texting lab and Hagrid's dragon lab. In the driving while texting lab, we used our own bodies to propel the scooter forward and get more momentum. Gymnasts use their own body to give themselves enough power to do hard skills. In the Hagrid's dragon lab, we designed the best dragon that we could to make it go as far and as fast as it can go. We thought about the forces acting on the dragon, like air resistance and friction, to make it move quicker. Gymnasts wear skin-tight leotards and pull back their hair to lessen the air resistance. If we wore puffy shirts, it would be harder to move fast, and if we didn't pull our hair back, it would have the same effect. Not to mention, it gets really annoying. We also use grips on the bar to increase the friction so that we don't slip off. Knowing the physics of gymnastics can benefit me as an athlete because now I have a better understanding of what makes me jump higher, run and flip faster, and what brings me to the ground. Also, knowing the physics of my sport can help me prepare for a new skill that I'm learning.
First, we have the grappling.
That's what makes me fall. Then we have air resistance throughout the giant.
New mat, suck.
Okay.
We also have friction between my hands and the bar.
Speed, acceleration, and force of your giants.
Well, I'm going to tell you. First, to find the speed, I time when I brought my legs together in my cast to the bottom of the bar. And then, that's also half of my circumference, which is 596.6 centimeters, or 5.97 meters. Distance over time. Now I'm going to substitute my numbers.
divided by 0.817. When I divide that, I get 7.4 meters per second.
And that's my speed. Now I'm going to show you the formula for acceleration.
The formula is A equals final velocity minus initial velocity divided by the time. So now I substitute my numbers in. So it's 7.4 meters per second, subtract 0 meters per second, divided by 0.816. My acceleration is 9.1 meters per second squared. And I got meters per second squared because when you're dividing, you have to use the copy dot flip system, so it's meters per seconds multiplied by 1 over seconds. And then you multiply across to get meters per second squared.
Now I'm going to show you how I calculated the force that I'm doing.
First, write down the formula.
F, force, equals mass, M, times acceleration,
M. So, to my numbers in, my mass is 39 kilograms, and my acceleration was 9.1 meters per second squared. When I multiply that, I get 355 kilograms times meters per second squared.
To get newtons, I have to show the substitution. 1 newton is equal to kilograms, 1 kilogram times meters per second squared.
So my answer is F equals 355
my answer and my momentum was 3 kilograms 10 meters per second.